What's up, everybody? A Sparrow with a Gun here from Sleepless Nights with another episode on No Man's Sky. When we left off in the last episode, I'm gonna admit, it's been a long week for me. I kind of forgot what I was doing. But I actually was playing a little bit off camera, because my cousin had gotten on and he was talking to me about it, and it just got me excited. I was like, I kind of want to actually play this a little bit more. And then I ran across something I'd never come across before, so then I had to stop because I wanted to show it, because I'd never seen it. So maybe you hadn't either. I thought this was a building, and then it comes up as platinum. And I was kind of like, okay. I didn't actually see this debris here. That's cool. But yeah, I totally, like, missed this as far as, not missed it. It just surprised me because I showed up, and I don't know what this comes up as on the marker. Depot. Okay, so it comes up as a depot. I already saved the checkpoint. But yeah, when I went to go, like, interact thinking, okay, it's like a building or something, and there was no doors, there was just these things that can be destroyed for platinum, so unless I'm missing something, and there's a depot back in here somewhere, oh, there is actually blueprints over there. So there's a knowledge thing up there, it looks like. So yeah, I kind of want to blow these up. There is this pesky little sentinel over here. One other thing, let me run real quick over to my ship so that I'm not standing out here in the hazard zone. I think this episode might revolve a little bit around milestone hunting, because I'm actually really close to quite a few milestones. I don't know how many distance the units thing here is, so I don't know how close I am on that one, but one alien to be found, 9 words to be found. Don't know about that one, because I've got a ways to go on that one, ways to go on that one. Well, that's not too bad, but Sentinels destroyed 3. If I blow up some stuff and attract some attention, that won't be hard. I'm not in an extreme biome. One more warp. And this one was interesting. Naturalist. Discover all species on one planet. Now, I don't know if that's, like, this records thing, or if it's down here, like, you actually have to discover all the species. Because I thought... Why can't I view that? Oh, that's a system. I guess I still have some residual things that I hadn't uploaded. Eventually, I am going to start renaming things. But, like, no, I guess I haven't completed a record. I thought I had. That must have been a not-so-pleasant world. That one doesn't even have a record. Okay, I must have discovered that and not been there. No record. I'm thinking it's the records. I could be wrong. Come on. I think it's the records, though. That one doesn't have one. That one doesn't have... Okay. Or it does, but I haven't done it. So I thought I actually completed a record. I guess I haven't. So yeah, I'm kind of thinking this might be a milestone hunt this episode and see how many of these we can knock out. I know I can do the words, sentinels, and... Maybe, depending on the amount of species, we might be able to pull off species. I'm not sure. I want to see what happens when I blow this up, though. Wait, is that even doing anything? I don't think that is. Oh, that's doing something. Grenades! Uh-oh. Alright, where's the sentinels? Die, please. Thank you. Where's the other guy? Oh no! Oh no, he's almost full. Woo! There we go! Oh yeah, I said that already. So there's 3. OK, Okay, I don't have much space though. I really need to get rid of these somehow. Let's throw you over there. Can I? My warp drive's full. Poo. So I could probably sell these. I don't know. What does it cost me to make a warp cell? I need antimatter, and for the antimatter, I need heridium. I have zinc somewhere. Okay, yeah, I have zinc over here. I have 47, so I can make two. I'm just gonna discard this one, because we don't really need it. The aluminum seems pretty good to keep on hand. Oh, wow, I'm a dum-dum. So under total value, there's actually a units per unit, basically, that actually tells you what it's worth. So carbon is virtually worthless. How about iron? Nah, not much. Yeah, I could totally sell these if I'm not going to actually use them for anything, and it would be worth it. So I could take plutonium and make another one of those. That seems like a good idea. Wow. Wow. Okay, hold on a second. I need to confirm a theory real quick here. I just think I might have found a decent money-making scheme if I really wanted to. Okay, so look at this. If I got this right, a warp cell is worth 46,000 per unit. It requires antimatter, which is heridium and zinc, neither of which are terribly hard to come by. Plutonium, carbon. So you make you take carbon, you make these. You take plutonium, you make these. You take those two, you make those. You make a warp cell, and then you sell it for like 46 grand. So that actually wouldn't be a bad thing to do. There was a knowledge fragment over here somewhere. Knowledge stone. Sorry, I'm never gonna get that right. Not ever. I don't think I can do my... Oh, there's the little blueprint thingy. Okay. Thaumium. Eh, I can get more in space. Alright, where are you? Oh, there's two of them over there. Okay, there's one right here. And I had mentioned before, units. I also did find one or two words for Corvax here and there while I was playing before I found that. I can confirm, too, that I had thought I read somewhere there was like 45 words per language or something like that. And again, in talking to my cousin, he said that he already had like 70-something in just Corvax or something. So that wasn't... I don't think that was accurate. I mean, I have no idea myself, but that doesn't seem like an accurate thing. Wait, how's... Oh, okay, let's do some management here. Probably need to go sell things. Yeah, that's not bad. Okay, where are those fragments? They should be right in front of my face. There's one. Word for language. Brain. I am actually looking forward to the day when I can actually just see what they're telling me. When I just look it up. Yeah, so we need to find an outpost. I think that's my next... Oh, yeah, I need that blueprint thingy. Ooh! And let's try and scan things, too. If he'll stop moving around like a jackrabbit. Toxin protection. 40. You know what? I think I might have actually scanned that thing already. Now that I'm looking at it. Okay. What are you gonna give me? Already known. I still have yet to come across any of that... Ow! the heck? Oh, it's one of those crazy plants. That stuff scares me more often than not. Like, it didn't actually do that much damage to my shields or anything. It just, like, startles me, because I'm just running along, and then it's like, BAM! Oh, come on now. Oh, that... Yeah. Okay. We'll get that one over there. I'm trying to collect some zinc, though, just because that does seem important for your warp cell. Wait a minute. Is there really one, like, right next to my ship and I did not know this? How did I not know that was there? Dark. Nabbit. Tissue! That seems like a useful word, I guess. Hey, Korvac's robot guy that's totally not human, bring me a tissue. Yeah, so I guess our next course of action is gonna be to fly around and look for... And here's an interesting thing, too. I had said I'd had a hard time finding carbon, so I was using the thaumium, which is still probably a better option. But I actually have two sets of carbon now. So I might actually start using my carbon a little bit, since it's actually the least valuable of the two. And I'll just keep, like, one full one on my ship, because the ship holds 500. And if I'm just using it for crafting and talking to people, I shouldn't need too much more than that. Actually, it's plutonium that I need more of. You know what? Before I leave here, now that the sentinels have calmed down a little bit, I am actually going to grab some of this plutonium. Because it's just too... There's too much here to pass up. At least till I get the, at least till I can get my ship one full. Oh, that's interesting. It, like, auto... activates them. Hold on now. Now that's not fair. I can't get to him. How's he even seeing me? Alright, well... That stinks. Wait, that's... Oh, that's platinum! I'm a derp. I'm a derp. This is giving me platinum, not plutonium. How did I not know that? How did I not see that? Oh boy. Oh, we've been at a two before. That shouldn't be a big deal. Okay, where's the other guy? Boom! I need to remember to use my grenades, man. Those things are effective. I totally did not realize I was getting platinum. That's so funny. Oh, I didn't even know that. That's hilarious. Okay, see, all of these are more valuable than carbon, so as much as I don't want to just, like, get rid of carbon, I kind of might. Because it just makes more sense to do that, actually. Like, all these are 40, blah, 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 blah. What is platinum, actually? Platinum's 55 per unit. Carbon's, like, 7. So, well, here's what I think I'm gonna do. I'm gonna get rid of this. And I kind of... Oh. Already known. Grenade propulsion. I don't know if that said already known or not. I didn't really check it. Damage radius already known. So you could basically just farm titanium and, titanium, and what's the other one I'm thinking of? Well, blueprint schematics. Fighter destroyed 30 sentinels. Oh, okay. Oh, wait. That's what was coming up saying I didn't have any inventory. Dang nabbit. I hit triangle to change my weapon type. Wasn't exactly trying to blow that up. Okay, let's skedaddle here. Okay, so here's what I'm gonna do. I need to refill the... well... no, I actually don't. So let's just take off. I'm finding it takes about a quarter of your thruster every time you launch. Kind of seems to be the thing. Okay, there's 2 points here. I really would like to... I'd like to see them both. But... I really need a place to sell stuff. And... let's see what this is. I have some plutonium I could refuel. Whoops. What is this? Oh! Hi! Speaking of needing to sell things, what are you doing just out here in the middle of nowhere? That's different. Alright, so let's just sell you. We're gonna sell you. Ooh. Platinum will give me 7,000. Ooh, what is that? Radnox. Okay. I just realized I'm in my ship, my personal inventory. Okay, I gotta, like, re-talk to this guy or something. The screen was glitching. Oh, maybe that's just its thing. Okay. I guess that's just its thing. Oh, this is interesting. I can't sell out of my ship. Well, I'm pretty sure I have a full platinum in there, so we're just gonna get rid of that. Anything I need from you? Power cell? No. I could, well, no, I can't. I was gonna say I could buy heridium, but I already sold the stuff that I needed to make it. Make the warp cell. And I don't need a warp cell, I'm full, so. This is random though. Like there's just a, I didn't know there were just these random terminals here. That's kind of cool. Oh, that's right. I need to be scanning life forms. I think I've already scanned him. So I'm guessing if it has the green dot, it means you've uploaded it. If it has the red dot, it means you scanned it. And if it doesn't have a dot, then you haven't found it. Like this doesn't have a dot. I scanned a new plant. I think. Well, it says it's already discovered, but it's not coming up with a red dot. I just walk around like this, just scan stuff. What is that thing? Oh, it's a sentinel. Platinum. One of these days, though, I am going to get around to naming things. Oh, knowledge stone. Hey, I got it right! After saying I'll never get it right, I got it right. Give me that. Because I'm actually going to need a decent amount of plutonium. I need to refuel my thruster. Research. I think I've already scanned these guys. That's a sentinel. What is that? Oh, that's a signal scanner. Sweet. Oh, that makes me... that reminds me. I actually got an interesting little tidbit when I was talking to my cousin. Oh, there's two. There's two more things over here. One of which was if you're... if you're scanning, not scanning, if you're using one of those signal scanners, he said to look for transmissions and we can find broken ships sometimes, among other things. Owie! I had been wondering how to find broken ships and stuff, because I had a couple people mention, you know, might not want to worry about buying a ship because you can find them and, like, repair them. And I was like, I've never come across one. Word for failure. That's funny. It's like, hey, how do you know if you failed or not? Well, you learn the word for failure. Already known. Okay. Anything else? Don't think anything I need. Zuppy Valley. I just realized the name of that. That's a weird name. You can actually mine from a fairly decent far range, actually. Okay. Oh, I need to sell some stuff while I'm right here. Kind of no point in, Oh, wait a minute. Why don't... Oh, that's... Never mind. I got it. This is gonna be the power hog. Which is which? Okay, that one is my ship. Yeah. Okay. So I'll save my ship one. Let's recharge that. Oh, wait. I actually want to... I didn't realize my gun was that low. Okay. Let me sell a couple of things, and then we're going to run over to that signal scanner thingy-ma-bobber. And I really wasn't in a spot where I could record any of this last week, so this episode's going to be a little bit more of the typical. I think the next episode will probably start implementing a bit more of a highlight reel type style, where I'm just going to do little snippets and kind of mash them all together and not show every little step of gameplay kind of thing. Let me know what you guys think about that, as far as if you're okay with that or if you'd rather see everything like 100%. I just feel like I can make more progress in the game and we could actually get a little further, and it may not come across quite so like, hey, we're still mining on the same planet and still trying to do random crap. Oh, this is all emerald. And there's a sales guy right there. Like that. Like, I could make a lot of money by doing that and, like, just chopping that whole thing down. But... you know, it's just, it's tedious and it's boring, and I don't want to waste you guys' time with all that. Let's make one of these. Let's try this transmission thing, see what we get. Signal scanner online, planetary location beacons are responding, so let's do transmission, because I don't actually think I've done one of those before. Maybe I have. Observatory detected. Huh. Observatory. Well, that's new. I think. Okay, do I have any room for any more emerald? I do. Let's fill up our ship's emerald supply here. How much can I hold? Oh, wow. I can hold a lot. I think I've got somewhere in the... I'm not going to be real precise about this, though. Ain't nobody got time for that. I haven't exactly figured out why sentinels will attack you if you're mining, like... I don't, if you're mining, like, plants and crap, they attack you. I randomly got carbon because I think I shot a plant behind me. But like this, I'm tearing up this, like, mountainside, and they're not even worried about it. If I break that platinum plant, or plutonium plant, though, then they'll be upset. I don't get it. Maybe they just don't care about, like, cosmetically valuable minerals, and they're only worried about, like, isotopes or something. Wow. This is an interesting formation here. What do we got? 74? Alright, I'm gonna pause it for a second. Okay, I take that back. I guess there was just no sentinels around when I normally do this, because watch this. Oh, great. Literally, right as I record, now they're not going to do it. Okay. That's hilarious. So, I broke some plutonium plants over here, or crystals, and then they flew over and scanned me, to which then I shot this once, and then they came flying over and was like, hey, what are you doing? And so I started recording to show it. Now they're not doing it. Typical Sentinels. So, mostly cleared that out. 124,000. I'm totally okay with that. Need to sell that pearl, but to do that... Oh, I need to get back in range of my ship and give it back to me. You know what I just thought of, too? Ooh, I'm getting a frame rate issue here. I didn't think about the birds. Have I scanned them before? I guess not. So there's another new discovery record. So 5 of 9. Is that what that... Is it saying I have 5 of 9? 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah. So I have 5 of 9. And when you finish a record, some of you have probably already seen this, you get 200 and some odd thousand credits depending on what planet and how many records it is, I guess. Okay, give me this back. I might want to sell that aluminum. And let's just sell the emerald, because I don't really need it. Oh, okay, it does split it into two stacks. Somebody had mentioned that to me, that I didn't actually lose value when I was selling things on a... transferring from my ship to my person. I was thinking I was losing my inventory, but either I did and they fixed it, or I did not and I just thought I did. Okay. Alright, so we're actually up to 700,000 units, so we're doing pretty good. Now, let's refuel some stuff. How much space do I have? 382. Okay, that'll make 2 stacks. Good. My titanium is full. My platinum is full. I could probably sell the platinum, but I've seen it in crafting mats, so... recipes, so I actually want to hang on to that for a minute, I think. Let's use up this little bit of carbon first. And then we'll go back to our thaumium for most everything else. Oops. Okay, what else do I have? I know my mining laser. Oh, I just recharged that. Swear some days if my brain wasn't attached to my head, I'd lose it. Okay, so let's go head over to this observatory and see what that stuff's all about. I could have probably just run over here, actually. Oh, that's kind of cool. Don't mind me, I'm just gonna land over here by the little acid pond. That's what it looks like. At least that's what it looked like from the air. Defar Marsh. What do we got going on here? Knowledge stone, material... Knowledge stones, that's probably a decent clip away. I think there's one way over there. Okay. Ooh, a full antimatter. That's cool. Now, speaking of antimatter, that's just thaumium. Yeah, so we're just going to go ahead and make a warp cell, because either I sell it and it's more valuable, or I can just use it and refuel my ship. Either way. Antimatter's totally worth it. Alright, now where was all that other stuff? Because my range has actually increased, that's actually a decent clip away from what I thought it was. But I guess it's not that far. Criminal! Yay, so at least I'll know if they're telling me I'm a criminal or not. Okay. phase beam already known. Okay. Oh, now this is interesting. Knowledge stone and a blueprint for damaged machinery. Accelerated fire. Photon cannon fires at an increased rate. Starships. Always a good word to know in a space environment. You know, so you can say things like, my starship's gonna blow up! Help me! Or, I need a starship to get off this planet! You know, just little things like that. Starship's just always a good one to have in your inventory. In your dictionary. Alright. So, now, let's start giving this a once-over. And I always interact with these, because I'm never really sure if they're ever going to give me anything really cool or not. Most of the time, they just try and recharge my shields. But it's that one time that you don't do it, and then it'll be like, you missed that huge thing. What is that? Oh, restore shields. See what I mean? Ooh, multi-tool. Technology discovered. Bolt caster companion ammo clip capacity is raised to its highest potential. Oh, and that's only plutonium, zinc, and nickel. That's pretty cool. I'm stuck. And there is another signal scanner here, which I find to be quite handy and dandy. Oh, and I think I only need to meet one more alien person for me to get another milestone marker for diplomacy or something. Yay! Person! Wait, have I talked to him already? Maybe I have, because it didn't give me carbon. Lifeform, clarify lifeform intelligence? Clarify how smart you are. The life form shows me complicated creature research data to see if I can comprehend it. I must look blank because the life form instead projects three holographic images into my visor. It's clearly seeking my opinion on the intellect level of my own species. I am shown a vacant-looking slug, a more advanced beaked traitor, and a member of its own vastly intelligent electronic race. So, here's the thing. Most people would like to this is almost one of those, like, memes. You know, the what people think I do, what I actually do, what I think I do, you know, stuff like that. This is one of those memes. What people think we should pick. Oh, humans are as advanced as this vastly intelligent electronic race. What I probably should pick is beaked. What I think we should is point to the slug. Because people are stupid. The life form is clearly expecting this answer. Haha! It has readied a technology blueprint for me. Deflection enhancement. Starship energy shield is strengthened. Now, wait a minute. Wait. Hold on. What do I have? Oh, I do have a deflection enhancement. Okay. So you could add multiple deflection enhancements then, I'm guessing. Because they're all plus ones, but they're all like tau, theta, sigma. So I'm guessing they're named different so that you could, like, have different ones. We need a ship with more slots before I start doing that kind of crap. Yeah, I figured that's the answer, but I kind of wanted to point to the slug just to see what happened. Entity. The lights in the electronic lifeform's casing start to brighten. It jerks its head sharply to the right, a strange buzzing noise signaling an onrush of unseen data. The download over it downgrades communication channels to those of conventional speech. Oh, okay, good. Thanks for talking down to my level. Just point at the slug. Future. Okay, so I guess... Wait a minute. Hold on. One word for interpreter. Where's the emissary? Oh, okay. I had five to go. That's what confused... I was like, I've not been here before, though. How come I didn't get the milestone thing? Yeah, that's what it was. Okay, that makes way more sense now. Still haven't figured out how to... I need to, like, do more with the Atlas progression stuff to figure out how to do my milestone... My milestone. My upgrade for the Atlas Pass. Now, wait a minute. What? Trace and target nearby lifeforms regardless of species or sentience. Ignition occurs upon collision. Huh, so it's like a seeker homing grenade. Ooh, now that is cool. So I guess that upgrade thing, what is this one? Propulsion launches at a higher velocity. What would it cost me to do the other one? Wow, I got a lot of them. Damage radius, intensity, rebound, intensity, propulsion, homing. Aluminum and gold. I need to stop selling things. I have a lot of money and I can't craft anything. So I guess that milestone just took a minute to kick in, is my guess. Like, yeah. I'm guessing that just took it a second to kick in and I actually had achieved what I thought I had. So I did only need one. I got one. And then it just took a minute, but the milestone had already cleared, I guess. Oh, can I interact with this? Oh! The observatory's sterile functional layout suggests its former overseer could have been electronic in origin. Really? You don't say! Judging by the decades-old beacon flashing on the screen, this entity left this place long ago. Uh-huh. Perhaps if I can decipher the code, I can learn where the beacon originated. Looks like another rotating. So 2916. Bingo! I learn of a new location in the cosmos. Ooh! So, I'm supposed to be tracing where the signal originated from, and I get the location of a monolith? Interesting. Okay. One other thing I wanted to test, too. Since I have a decent amount of carbon... Go ahead and refuel that. Yeah, I've got a decent amount of carbon still. I also heard about that you can continue to talk to these people, and I think it's every 3 or 4 you can ask them for like an isotope and it usually gives you carbon. So I wanted to try that theory since we have some extra carbon. As long as he doesn't get mad at me. Entity. Traveler. I still have so many words to learn, apparently. The electronic lifeform pauses its work, looks up, and focuses its mask lights on my visor. It waits for my request, but seems desperate to get back to its vital research. Requests fuel. I think that... Let's try that. I think that's going to be the isotope. He agrees to help. Yeah, okay, so he gave me 94 carbon. So that's what I was, again, in talks with, when I was talking to my cousin about this, he mentioned that you could talk to them like 3 or 4 times, and every 3 or 4 you usually get the option for fuel, and then you can use it, and then go back and talk to them again, and continue to repeat the process if you wanted to, like, grind out words kind of thing. Anyways, I think we're gonna wrap things up for this episode. In the meantime... like I said, I may try and do, some more montage-type stuff and do a little more playing off-camera and just record little snippets or things that I think are cool kind of thing, if you guys are interested in that. So let me know what you guys think about that in the comments. In the meantime, I hope y'all enjoyed. If you did, leave a like, and I'll see y'all next time. Peace.